Hello everyone and welcome to this video. I'm Chiaro from Seme Cosplay and I'm going to explain how Seme made this Dimitri cosplay from Fire Emblem Three Houses. I'm going to share some tips and tricks if you want to craft the costume yourself. Of course, there are many different ways to do this and this is just one of them. First, Seme made all the patterns, scaled them to size, printed and glued them together, and cut them out. For the details, she cut into the foam, approximately halfway into the foam, with a precision knife. Then she heated the foam up with a hot air gun to make it malleable. To make the details last, Seme filled the ridges with hot glue, dampened her fingers with cold water and smoothed over the glue with her fingers. Then she heated the foam with a hot air gun to curve the outside of the foam. Seme then glued on Velcro to connect the front and the back of the armor later. These are the cutout pieces for the shoulder armor that she connects with glue. Here you can see the finished shoulder armor that she now glues onto the chest armor. These Velcro pieces are needed to give the shoulder armor something to grip onto later. Seme uses silicone sealant paste to fill in all the gaps and smooth over them with wet fingers. Now she glues on the hip armor onto the back piece. Then she cuts out all the details for the chest armor. These are the sleeve details that she now glues onto the sleeve and forms with hot air. Seme makes some final touches to the pattern and then glues on the sleeve. she uses even more Velcro on the collar so that you can close it. Then Semi uses tiny pieces of foam to enforce the openings of the chest armor from the inside to make it sturdier. To make this cross detail, she cuts it out first, then marks the middle and uses a V-cutter to cut into the back side of the cross. She uses the hot air gun to form it, and then she puts glue into the cuts to make it more three-dimensional. As a final touch, she cuts the edges to make them more even. Before priming, she prepped everything with a hot air gun to seal it. The armor is black now because Seme used Plasti-Dip as a primer and then sprayed it with black paint. And now she paints on metallic details with a brush and a sponge. When bending the foam for painting, it can get a little bit crinkly. But this can be fixed by just using a hot air gun and heating it up later. Then Semi uses a Posca pen to paint on some metallic details. And this is the final product. Semi made the bracer armor in a similar fashion. For the details, she uses a soldering iron. Please make sure to take necessary precautions if you want to do this yourself. Make sure to wear a suitable mask when working with spray paint or, in this case, fumes. And protect your hands from heat with special gloves and use disposable gloves when working with glue or paint. You should also wear goggles to protect your eyes. The markings that you can see on the bracer here are to indicate where the smaller armor pieces go. Semi uses elastic band as a closing mechanism for the braces. Here you can see Plasti-Dip in action. But remember, kids, what I told you about gloves and masks and goggles. After priming it and spraying it with black paint, she paints on the silver details once again. As a final touch, she uses a clear varnish. If you don't have a spraying booth, maybe do this outside or open a window. And this is the final look. Now you can see how Seme made the elbow pads. Et voila! And this is how she made the two leg armor parts. Remember to open your window. So much paint. And drum roll, please. This is the last part, the shin guard. Here, Seme uses tape to help her with painting. More clear varnish to seal everything. And done! If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. And if you want to commission Seme yourself, check out Seme Cosplay on Etsy or semecosplay.com. You can find all links in the description of this video. Goodbye!